Hello and welcome to Susie B Living's Moon Phase Gardening series. I'm sorry I'm a little bit late this week because I've been away, so I've actually missed Monday, which is today. Sorry about that, but it doesn't matter. So I'm going to give you the next week coming up from Tuesday the 6th of February all the way through to Sunday the 11th of February. So let's start with, if you're following me on my moon phase gardening schedule, then you know the drill. And if you're not, hello and welcome to my moon phase gardening schedule. We're getting closer to spring, so it's nice to have a little bit of a schedule and know what you're doing and when. And that's how, and so I do it through the moon phases and mainly through the constellations. So particular days represent particular types of plants. So for instance, Tuesday the 6th, Wednesday the 7th, and Thursday morning the 8th a.m. are all fruits days in the moon phase calendar. And fruits days mean anything that really has a seed in it. So for instance, I'll give you an idea of what I'm doing. I'm looking down at my notes here. So my little schedule consists of sowing, transplanting, weeding and maintenance, and feeding and watering. That is all that I do within these days. And sometimes I don't only get to do one thing, but it keeps me on track all the time. And I'm well ahead for the year, because if you do follow me, you know that I grow all year round. So let's go back to fruits. So for my sowing, I am going to sow some sugar snap peas. Now, I've already sown a tray of sugar snap peas, and then I sowed another tray and the germination wasn't great, but they're really old seeds. So the first tray, I think, was probably a fluke. But my next lot of sugar snap peas that I'm going to sow are going to be like a dual purpose pea. I'm going to use the tips just to eat, like in salads or whatever I sprinkle them on. And then I'm going to let them continue growing into proper sugar snap peas. The first lot of pea shoots, I suppose you call it, I grew in long trays. I sprinkled all the seeds on top, grew them in trays, grew them in the greenhouse. They are my earlier variety called Meteor. Okay, they're okay. They're not hugely tasty, but these ones I am going to grow in cells, in little modules, and I am going to grow 3 seeds per module, as I would for kind of normal peas that I grow outside. And then I'm going to plant them out, and like I say, take the tips off where here or there and everywhere, and let them grow then to be sugar snaps. So I'm going to be sowing those. I'm also going to be transplanting some more strawberries. So if you want early strawberries, you can bring them inside. So you can put plants and make sure that if they're going to come from runners from your garden, they really need to be about 2 years old, the runners. Otherwise, you're not going to get a proper crop from the strawberries. They're too young. So if you've just taken runners from last year, don't bother, because it's going to be a waste of compost and a waste of the pot, really. I mean, you'll get a few, but you won't get a huge amount. But I noticed that in garden centers at the moment, they have got pots, little pots of strawberries available. I'm not talking about bare-rooted. Bare-rooted strawberries won't work this way. Again, you might get a small crop, but you're not going to get anything big. They need to actually be in a pot. But what you can do is you can buy them. They sometimes have multi-packs of them. You can buy them and then pot them up into pots and put them undercover. So I'm talking about something like a greenhouse or in a conservatory or in a utility room, a laundry, anything like that. And you will then bring them on. They then start thinking, oh, hello, it's spring and going into summer. And they will then produce much earlier than the outside ones. There are 2 varieties that I like to do. One is called Sweetheart. It's an early variety here in the UK, and it's really lovely. I've also got it in the garden. And the other one is a kind of mid-season variety, and it's the Mara de Bois. And it is absolutely delicious. So they're the two that I'm going to put undercover. And I've already started. So these are just a few extras that I'm going to do. The other thing that I'm going to be sowing is, this is my second to last sowing of peppers and chilies. So I've already got some. And here they are. They're looking very nice. This is my second lot here. And they're ready to transplant on. And I'll talk about that in a minute when I talk about transplanting. So I am going to be sowing. So I've had a look to see how many I've got of each. And now I'm going to do my next sowing. I am going to sow Lemon Dream, which is my lovely yellow, little yellow one. I'm going to sow Bright Star, which is an F1. It's an orange one. And then I'm going to sow Akron as well, my red one as well. Giallo, the Corno Giallo, the long yellow one. I'm going to sow those. Now I'm sowing three of each of those. Then I'm going to add to that, and I am sowing two that I did last year, which was New Ace, which is an F1. And that is a lovely thin fleshed pepper, really good for salads. And the other one is Red King. And I'm going to be sowing six of each of those to make up for what I've already got, because I haven't sown those yet. They just don't need as long a season as these ones. And also, because they're bigger peppers, these are now my sowings for peppers that I'm going to use for preserving. So for chutneys, for chilies, and so that's why these ones go into the mix. I'm also going to do my first lot of tomatoes, and it is a tumbling type. So I'm going to put them in hanging baskets, and it's called Red Profusion. Again, it's an F1. And what I found last year with it, I like tumbling tomatoes. They're lovely because they work really fast. But this one in particular, it was a Red Profusion, and the tomatoes were delicious. So I'm going to be doing eight of those. That's my sowings for Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday morning. Transplanting. So these chilies that I've got here in these little cells, these ones, are now going to be transplanted up to my next size, which is what I've done here with these ones. Okay, so that's what I'm going to be doing for transplanting. I've also got some peas in the greenhouse, the Oregon sugar pod and the sugar snap peas. Now, I'm thinking about transplanting them out into the garden, but I'm a little bit of a loggerhead because we're going to be getting some very low nighttime temperatures in the middle of this week. So I am going to cover them anyhow. I will cover them with a polythene cloche. But I'm thinking about whether I might hold off a little bit before I put them out in the garden. I mean, it's no big deal because I can always sow again. But I might. So if you're going to, if you are in the UK and you have got peas and you want to put them out, you do need some kind of heavy coverage. So if you have a cold frame over the bed, fantastic. That should work. So yeah, I'm thinking about it. Weeding and maintenance is my next category. And again, I'm still on my fruit trees. So I'm going through my fruit trees. I'm cutting back anything that needs to be cut back, pear, and apple. And also I'm still in the citrus as well. I've been really slow with the citrus. I don't quite know why, but I have been a little bit slow. So that's my fruit stays. Thursday afternoon and Friday, the 9th of February, are both roots days. So I will be sowing my first lot of shallots. I sow shallots. If you go back and have a look, I did a video on what I am sowing in February. It's two parts, part one and part two, because I've got quite a lot that I'm sowing. In the first part, you'll see that I do my first lot of shallot sowing, and those are sets. The second part is where I talk about where I do them from seed, and they're different shallots. So the first shallots that I'm doing from sets are Golden Gourmet. They're a lovely round shallot here in the UK, a little bit flatter, you know, your kind of typical shallot. I'm going to be doing those, and I'm going to be doing another one called Red Sun. Again, they're little round ones, but they're like a pinky, reddy colour. They are going into modules. I haven't got the size here. They're going into modules and I'm going to start them off in the greenhouse. So that's my first lot of sowing. My second lot of sowing is I'm starting my super early potatoes. And the way that I grow potatoes, these early potatoes, is I put them in 11 centimeter pots. And depending on the size of potato, I might put 2 potatoes per pot with a little bit of compost. I wait for them to sprout. It takes about 3 to 4 weeks because I keep them inside. So I'm keeping them relatively warm. So it takes 3 to 4 weeks. And then once they've sprouted, I then pot them on. The varieties that I particularly like this time of year are Swift. That is, as it says, it is very fast. And the other one that's very fast is one called Winston. It's better tasting than Swift, but both of them are really fast. And I also start off some Charlotte as well. The Charlotte is my saved seed, and the other two I've bought in because they don't really store well, whereas Charlotte will store really well. So that is my sowing on the roots days. For transplanting, I have red onions that were sets that I've grown in the greenhouse, and they're now sprouting and they're looking really good. So I am going to transplant those out. I'm deliberating where. Am I going to do it on the allotment? I think I will probably do it on the allotment, but I have to cover everything on the allotment for Allium leaf miner. So I have got a space and I will probably put them over on the allotment. They have to go out. I also still have some spring onions in little cells like this. And they've got to go out as well. So they're going to be transplanted out. For my weeding and maintenance for roots, let me talk about what I've got. So I've got my winter radish that I'll have a good look at, take the old leaves off. Garlic. So all my garlic has finally come up now. That bed that I was talking about much earlier in my videos, that there was no movement, is now starting to come up. I've got leeks. I've got turnips in the veggie pod. They're looking quite nice. I'm still not sure whether they're going to bolt or not, go to flower or not, but I've got my eye on them. And then I've got my normal radish that I've also transplanted out, and I'll, so we need to have a look at that. I had a quick look at it today because, again, it's in my veggie pod. And I had a quick look today and they're doing really well, really well. They're growing really nicely. So that is Thursday and Friday. Saturday, the 10th of February this week, is an unfavorable day. So that gives me a chance to do some tidying up, some cleaning outside, some sweeping, some, you know, moving pots again. I'm always moving pots. It's just quite unbelievable. And that's Saturday. And then Sunday, the 11th of February, is Flowers Day again. So let's talk about the edible flowers. I am going to be sowing some more graffiti cauliflowers, and they are the purple ones. I'm only going to sow 4 or 5 of them just to tide me over with the ones that I've got that I'm because that's my next thing I'm going to transplant out. So I've got some graffiti cauliflowers ready to transplant out. I'm going to put some in the greenhouse over on the allotment, and then the rest of them I'm thinking I might keep them here at home. But they are definitely worth sowing. And doing an early sowing like this, they will be out of the ground before you need the ground for other things. So that's what I'm going to be sowing. The other thing is, I said in earlier videos that I'm now going to cover ornamental flowers. So if you want to sow any ornamental flowers, it's a good time to start sowing your hardy annuals. And I mean things like Ami Magus, some dill. If you're growing dill for flowers, then dill, you can sow dill this time of year, no problem. Calendula is really good at this time of year. So is Cerinthy Major, you know, the kind of, do they call that the shrimp plant? I'm not sure. But yeah, so that's, you can sow as well. And also any scabious you can sow. Get your antirrhinums in as soon as possible because they need a long growing season. And also the Cobaea scandens, the cup and saucer plant, that needs a long season as well. If you want to think ahead and I'm thinking about autumn flowers, get some Nerine bulbs. Nerines are absolutely beautiful, but they need a long growing season, root development before they actually send out flowers. And you could put some nice ones in pots and just keep them aside. And then when autumn comes and everything is actually dying off, these come out. They are absolutely beautiful. They're mainly pinks, so you can get dark and light pinks and some whites. And I think they come in yellow as well. I think my mum has said something to me about yellow. So you can plant those in pots and they're beautiful. Snowdrops. Now, they're all out at the moment here in the UK. So this is a great time to dig them up and plant them in other places. Or if you haven't got any, get some from some friends because they multiply quite a lot. Get a few scoopfuls from some friends and plant them out, because snowdrops don't really work well when you plant the singular bulbs. You have to plant them in what they call in the green. And in the green means that they've got the green leaves coming up. And that's the best time to plant snowdrops. So February is a great time to multiply all your snowdrops around. Great time. The other thing this does well is you can plant Lily of the Valley. Just be careful with Lily of the Valley because it is invasive, really invasive. It likes a shady, cool spot. So it's a great plant to put in, you know, when you want somewhere that you think, oh, it's really shady here and nothing's going to grow. Lily of the Valley will grow and it smells divine. You can start your lilies in pots, get yourself some lilies and start those in pots ready for the summer. And the other thing is, have a look at your if you're overwintering dahlias, have a look at them, because they could be sprouting. If they're sprouting, they're ready to go. So take all the rotten stuff off them, all the mold, all the fungus, everything, and plant them up because they're ready to go. And that's the beauty of if you overwinter your own dahlias, because they do tell you when they're ready to go. So that's that. Transplanting, I've talked about my calabrese and my cauliflowers, and weeding and maintenance. I've just got to go and check my purple sprouting broccoli over at the allotment. I haven't looked at it for a while, and I just keep weeding the garden as we go along. And I tend to pay particular attention to anything that's flowering at the moment. They get number one priority. So I'm going to go back into my hellebore bed because they're all starting to come up. I've got quite a lot of grass in my hellebore bed, so I need to get in there again. And I noticed that I've got some anemone blanda coming up, and nemorosa as well coming up. So I need to weed all around those so we can enjoy those flowers. And that is your week of Moon Phase Gardening. So I hope I've given you some inspiration of jobs. You don't have to do them all. I don't do them all. I just make a list of what I can be doing. And then I don't have to go out into the garden and scratch my head and say, whoa, where do I start? Because I already know what I'm going to be doing. And that's it. I will see you next Sunday. I'm not going away again. So Sunday night, my Moon Phase Gardening series will come out. And I hope you have a great week, gardening week. I hope the weather will be nice with you. And my name's Susie B from Susie B Living. And if you hit the subscribe button, then you'll get all my videos. You'll be notified of when I load my videos. I don't only do these videos. I also do videos of what I am doing in the garden or what I'm sowing, all sorts of different things you'll see. And have a look at my what I'm sowing in February. Part one and part two, and that will give you an idea of my varieties that I use. Thanks very much. I'll see you next time. Bye.